Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. In this video, we shall discuss convection. You will see some exciting experiments on convection. Convection is a process in which heat is transferred by the movement of a fluid. Convection takes place in liquid or gas, which are collectively called fluid. Convection is possible only in fluid, but not in solid or vacuum. In fact, all candle flames take the form of a teardrop because hot air rises. But why does hot air rise? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. The reason for hot air rises is that air heat up will expand and become less dense than the surrounding air, therefore hot air rises. Because hot air rises, the air nearby will flow towards the flame to fill up the space. As a result, a convection current is formed in which hot air rises and cold air sinks. Look at this experiment. A spiral is cut from a thin sheet of metal. It is then suspended using a fan above a candle. Can you explain what happened when the candle is lighted? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. The spiral will take continuously because the rising air from the fan pushes the spiral. In the previous video, while it is difficult to ignite a matchstick, move it horizontally towards a flame, it is easy to ignite the matchstick when it is lowered downward. This is because air heated by the flame rises due to convection. The air above the flame is not heated through conduction. Instead, convection causes hot air to move upward. When the matchstick is moved to where the hot air is above 182 degrees Celsius, it will ignite. What is the shape of the flame if the candle is inverted? Would the flame point downward? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. In this experiment, both ends of the candle are lighted. Clearly, both flames take the shape of a teardrop. This is because hot air rises. On the other hand, the candle oscillates to and fro continuously. It is because candle is melted more quickly by a flame below. The side with the flame below will lose weight quickly. Eventually, it will move up so that the other side will take turn to have the flame below. This process repeats and the candle oscillates. One more experiment on burning candle. A beaker is separated into two chambers by a T-shaped paper cone, with candles burning on one chamber. Smoking paper is burned to produce smoke. The smoke rises due to the hot air heated by the burning paper. Explain what happened to the smoke when it is lowered inside the beaker. Pause the video for a while and answer the question. You can see that the smoke goes down. Let's explain this. The burning candle heats up the air above. As the hot air rises, air in the next chamber flows in to fill the space. As a result, air moves down in one chamber and rises on the other. As smoke moves with air, it goes downward. Let's look at the convection in a liquid. The liquid is specially designed to study convection. It consists of fine powder that enables us to see the movement of the liquid. When the liquid is heated, a convection current is formed and the liquid above the flame rises. This confirms that hot liquid always rises. A circulation is formed because the space must be filled up by neighboring liquid. In this experiment, the blue ice is prepared by freezing water with blue food coloring. The plastic bottle is filled with hot water mixed with red food coloring. Can you predict what happens when they are dropped into a tank of water? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. Result shows that the cold blue water sinks immediately, while the hot red water falls on the water surface for quite a long time. This experiment confirms that hot food rises and cold food sinks. In this experiment, two cylindrical vases contain red liquid and the other two contain blue liquid. The temperatures of the red and blue liquids are different. A plastic sheet is used to separate the liquids. From the result, can you tell which color represents a hotter liquid? Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. You are welcome to comment on the answers of other people. I hope this video can help you understand more about heat transfer by convection. Thank you for watching.